that your name? Julie? Julie something?
Julie Jordan.
You're a queer one, Julie Jordan. Ain't you sorry that you didn't run away? You can still go if you want her.
I reckon that I care to choose to stay. You couldn't take my money if I didn't have any, and I don't have a penny, that's true. And if I did have money, you couldn't take any, 'cause you'd ask and I'd give it to you.
You're a queer one, Julie Jordan. Have you ever had a fella you give money to?
No.
Ain't you ever had a fella at all?
No.
Well, you must have had a fella you went walking with.
Yes.
Where'd you walk?
Nowhere special, I recall.
In the woods?
No.
On the beach?
No.
Did you love him?
No, never loved no one. I told you that.
You're a funny kid. Want to go into town and dance, maybe?
No. No, I have to be careful.
Of what?
My character. You see, I'm never gonna marry. I'm never gonna marry. If I was gonna marry, I wouldn't have to be such a stickler. But I'm never gonna marry, and a girl who don't marry has got to be much more particular.
Suppose I was to say to you that I'd marry you.
You?
That scares you, don't it? But you wouldn't want to marry anyone like me, would you?
Yes, I would if I loved you. Wouldn't make no difference what you did. Not even if I died for it.
How do you know what you'd do if you loved me? Or how you'd feel, or anything?
I don't know how I know. Just the same, I know how would it be if I loved you? When I worked in the mill, weaving at the loom, I'd gaze absent-minded at the roof. And half the time the shuttle would tangle in the threads and the warp would get mixed with the woof. If I loved you. But somehow I can see just exactly how I'd be. If I loved you time and again, I would try to all I'd want you to know.
Well, anyway, you don't love me. That's what you said, wasn't it?
Yes. I can smell them, can you? The blossoms. The wind brings them down.
Ain't much wind tonight. Hardly any. You can't hear a sound, not the turn of a leaf, nor the fall of a wave hitting the sand. The tide's creeping up on the beach like a thief, afraid to be caught stealing the land. On a night like this, I start to wonder what life is all about.
And I always say two heads are better than one to figure it out.
I don't need you or anyone to help me. I got it figured out for myself. We ain't important. What are we? A couple of specks or nothing. Look up there. There's a hell of a lot of stars in the sky, and the sky's so big, the sea looks small. And two little people, you and I, we don't count at all. You're a funny kid. Don't ever remember meeting a girl like you. You, are you trying to get me to marry you?
No.
Then what's putting it into my head? You're different, all right. Don't know what it is. You look up at me with that little kid face like you trusted me. I wonder what it'd be like.
What?
Nothing. I know what it'd be like. It'd be awful. I can just see myself. Kind of scrawny and pale, picking at my food, and love sick like any other guy. I'd throw away my sweater and dress up like a dude in a dickie and a collar and a tie. If I loved you. But somehow I can see just exactly how I'd be. If I loved you time and again, I would try to say
I'm not a feller to marry anybody. Even if a girl was foolish enough to want me to, I wouldn't.
Don't worry about it, Billy.
Who's worried?
You're right about there being no wind. The blossoms are just coming down by themselves. Just their time to, I reckon.